across the country. We hear a lot about mass shootings happening in the United States, but at least 24 children and a pregnant teacher were killed by a former police officer who went on a shooting and stabbing spree at a daycare center in northeastern Thailand on Thursday, shortly after appearing in court on drug charges. Here's an excerpt from NBC News on that incident.
A really disturbing story out of Thailand this morning. Police now say, confirming in a press conference that just wrapped up, that 38 people have been killed in this mass shooting. That, according to Reuters, they say that 22, at least 22 of them were children at this daycare, which is about 300 miles north of the capital, Bangkok, along with two teachers and a police officer. This happened in the middle of the day. It was nap time for the kids, about 12:30 in the afternoon, when police say this gunman entered the daycare. He shot his way through a locked door, according to one witness, and that is where these children were sleeping. Police also saying, according to Reuters, just in this press conference, that he used a knife to kill the children. They also had two guns with him inside that daycare. He then fled in his car. Police say that he was shooting from his car, that he rammed people with his car. He then arrived home, shot his wife and child, and killed himself.
The details of this story are really disturbing. The suspect, whom police named as 34-year-old Panya Khamrab, you can see his picture right next to me. He had served at Na Wang's police station at Nang Bwang, Bom Phu province, until he was arrested with methamphetamines last year, officials said. Khamrab took his own life after the rampage. Reporting from NBC News again, the suspect had appeared in court hours earlier Thursday on a drug charge that led to him being fired from the police last year. Khamrab entered the center at lunchtime when about 30 children were present. Local official Jirapa Bunsum told Reuters, one teacher who was shot dead was 8 months pregnant, she said. In a statement on Facebook, Prime Minister Prayuth Chan-o-cha called the shooting a shocking incident. He added that he had ordered Lieutenant General Yang Yong Wech-a-Suth, the commander-in-chief of the police, to fly to Nang Bwa Lam Phu to take necessary actions and all involved parties to provide immediate relief to all affected people. The government said it would provide financial aid to the victims' families to help cover funeral expenses and medical treatment. Now, mass shootings are very rare in Thailand, but not unknown. In 2020, a soldier who was angry over a property deal gone sour killed at least 29 people and wounded 57 in a rampage that spanned four locations. John Ungam Korn, a former Thai senator, wrote on Facebook that Thailand should have strict gun control restrictions like Japan, England, and many European countries, but added that this would require a citizen-led government to be realized. So yeah, some solutions being proposed, but really a disgusting situation and one that seemingly could have been avoided. It seems like many people knew that this guy was not doing well. He was found to be on meth and now he has shot up a daycare. Just really devastating and shocking to hear about mass shootings of this nature happening somewhere other than the United States. Jackson, I want to bring you in here. What are your thoughts on this?
Yeah, this is definitely, I remember I got the notification for this real early in the morning. And, you know, this is definitely hard to see anytime it happens anywhere. And, you know, like you pointed out, you know, people were aware that he wasn't doing well. He got, you know, released from the police force because of methamphetamines. And his actions screamed a violent meth-induced rampage. He, you know, probably was depressed and did way too much of it. And I'm not diagnosing, but you know, again, methamphetamine was involved. He was depressed and he went on this rampage and killed his wife and child before he killed himself. So, you know, unfortunately, we often have to see things like this happen, but the difference between America and a lot of other nations is they oftentimes act on stuff like that. Now, that's not to say Thailand will, but this type of stuff happens over here all the time. And we've yet to really do anything about it whatsoever. So it's just, it sucks to see stuff like this because they were a bunch of kids, like, you know, like what the hell?
Absolutely. And then to have the government there say, we're going to step in and we're going to help pay medical and funeral expenses and give financial aid to these families. We have so many mass shootings in the United States. You never hear them offering that for these kinds of situations that play out in our own country. It's just disgusting. We don't take care of our own when we see that people are sick and not doing well and might be a risk for violence, right? This was a former police officer. The shooting in 2020 in Thailand was a soldier. These are people who are likely struggling with their mental health. Clearly drugs were involved. If we took care of each other and looked out for each other and had the resources to do so, we could avoid situations like this from happening. But it's disgusting that in the United States, even when situations like this happen, we don't even take care of our people afterwards. It's amazing that they're saying, yeah, we're gonna help cover the funeral costs and medical expenses. How expensive would it be if we offered that here in the United States? Maybe that would be a motivator for people to do something about gun control and mass shootings in the US so that their tax dollars don't keep going to covering funerals and medical expenses. Any last thoughts on this, Jackson?
No, unfortunately, I think that, you know, there really aren't words to put into how horrible this was. But all we can do is continue to fight here for better gun laws every way that we can, especially locally. You know, in terms of changing our law enforcement, everything, we have to up our ante and have to get more involved every single day.
That's very well said.